Well, the obvious influence for the Down and Outs is Mott the Hoople, because the only reason that the band exists is because of Mott the Hoople. Let me explain. I've been a fan since I was about 10 years old of Mott, and they split up in 74, and you know, they splintered. Ian Hunter, the singer, went solo. The rest of the band carried on under the name of Mott by dropping the Hoople off the name with a different singer and guitar player. And then that band splintered into a group called the British Lions. And then they all just went their separate ways, and some of them never worked again, and Ian Hunter never stopped working. But come 2009, I got a whisper that they were going to reform for some shows in London. And then I got a call from Ian and Trudy Hunter saying, we'd like you involved, because I'd been basically flying the flag for the band ever since Def Leppard became popular. And I'd get asked, who did you grow up listening to? They were always top of my list, which was a big surprise for a lot of people, because they thought I would be saying like Zeppelin or Deep Purple. And it was always more Mott, Bowie, T-Rex for me. When you're in a band that's as big as Def Leppard are, those stories get back to the band members. Have you heard what that guy in Def Leppard's been saying about us, you know? And so they wanted to, I guess, just say thanks for doing what you did. And I said, well, what do you want me to do? Thinking they wanted me to just maybe introduce them on stage. And they said, will you open for them on the last night of the five shows that they were doing in London? And I said, well, yeah, I will, but it couldn't be Def Leppard. It would take away from their glory if we were to do that. And so, no, we've got an idea. The Quireboys are available. Spikes, he's manfully, you know, stepped aside to let you front them, and they will be your band for the night. So I had 6 months to pull this round, and I started talking with Paul Gearing, the guitar player, and I said, okay, I'm going to pick 10 songs that I think would be perfect to open for Mott with. They had to be songs that weren't Mott the Hoople songs, so I chose a bunch of songs that they were all involved with after Mott split up. So there were Ian Hunter songs, there were British Lions, one British Lions song, and a ton of songs by Mott. And we picked 10 songs, and when I finally got into London about the 1st of October 2009, we met and shook hands like Englishmen do. And 2 hours later, we were hugging and going to the pub, because everybody had done their homework and we had these songs down, you know. And the whole idea of it was to do one show on October the 6th, I think it was. And we did the show, and then we were going to go our separate ways, and that was going to be the end of it. But as we kind of went out to the bar in the foyer during the interval, we had all these kids coming up going, I can't believe what I just heard, because I never thought I'd hear those songs ever again, especially on stage. Are you thinking of maybe recording them? And it never entered my head that we would. But I asked the guys, you know, we went backstage afterwards, we watched Mott, and then we all had a bit of a shindig with them later. And I said, what do you think about recording them while they're still fresh in our DNA? And so they said, sure. So they luckily have a friend that lived close by with a studio. So they went in the studio, and long story short, they recorded all 10 tracks in 2 days and then sent me the files to Dublin. And I went in the studio and I went between gigs. I picked at it until we finally had an album together. And that was the first Down and Outs album called My Regeneration, which came out in 2010. We gave it away in Classic Rock magazine in the UK, but we also put it on sale a few months later, and it was on sale in the States. And lo and behold, out of nowhere, I had a number five single at American radio with England Rocks, and Overnight Angels went to number one on American rock media-based radios. So it was like, wow, this is a whole new band. It's actually got legs, you know, this is insane. And we did a few shows with Paul Rodgers around the UK a year later. Did a huge festival in the UK, and then it went dormant because Quireboys were busy, I was busy, and then we got back together sometime in 2013, and we managed to pull together the second album, which was called The Further Adventures of the Down and Outs, which by then we were in a position to be able to cover Mott the Hoople songs, because we were now no longer opening for them. So we dipped into their catalogue with things like Marionettes and Driving Sister and Rock and Roll Queen, which again did really well for us at radio. From that little mini tour we did of the UK in 2014 came the live album, The Further Live Adventures of the Down and Outs. And then, of course, then he goes massively dormant, because Def Leppard's trajectory just started going through the roof, and it just got really difficult to pin down any time to start this record, really. I had the demos pretty much wrapped up, at least 7 of the 9 songs that got written. And then luckily I just started picking away at it, and then the guys were free and they'd come in, and Cher joined in 2014, so she was now on board, and she's a fantastic bass player. So I was really happy with this stable lineup. She's a third bass player. We were like Roxy Music, going through bass players like you wouldn't believe. And I like this lineup. It's a good bunch of people, and they understand my vision of where I wanted to go with this project. It had to be very different to what Def Leppard is, because as I've said many times, I can't see the point of being in two bands that sound identical. So it had to be very different. And most of the songs on this album were written on a piano. That gives it its absolute distinction from Def Leppard. So, you know, eventually we got the album finished just before this whole tour kicked off this year. So I've been sitting on it for like 6 or 7 months. We got the artwork completed and we delivered it. And now it's like just waiting to give birth. You know, it's like, come on already.